Hi, everybody. This is Prophetess Stephanie coming to you, and welcome to Simple Truths. This is talking about today, be more. I was reading a passage of scripture today in Ecclesiastes, and it was 2 and 24, chapter 2, verse 24. And it said, there is nothing better than for man than that he should eat and drink. Sorry, hold on a second. So sorry. That he should eat and drink, and that he should make his soul enjoy his good labor. Now, I don't know if everybody knows exactly what that entails or what that really means, but there's a lot that goes behind what is being said in this scripture. A lot of it is saying, hey, you know what, go out and enjoy your life. Have fun, spend your money, do all these things, because, you know, you can't take it with you, you know, and which is true, you know, we can't take it with us. But there's an extent of going out and doing excess, because sometimes the excess is a little, you can do a little too much. You can spend too much money. You can overdrink, you know, which ends up causing your liver to go bad. You can smoke to excess and you end up getting cancer and all of that stuff like that. Yeah, we're supposed to work hard, and some of us work too hard, and then we end up having a heart attack, you know. So I guess I wanted to say, more or less, this is do what you do and do what God is saying from his book. But God is saying also you have to do it in moderation, which is the behind the scenes part of this. Everything comes within moderation. You know, so if God is saying, you know, yeah, you can eat and you can drink and you can work hard, you know, but sometimes we don't take heed to his word the way that we should. The way that we should take heed to his word is we need to listen and obey and be obedient to the word. When we're not being obedient to the word, that's when you know, God's wrath ends up taking place in our lives, and we're trying to figure out, oh, how did we get here? Well, you got here because you didn't listen and you were doing stuff in excess. So that's when you have to come up and you have to literally change the way that you do things, change the way that you look at things, change the way that you look at yourself. Yes, you do have to be more. This is about being more. This is about doing more. This is about living more. This is about just more. Because God never promised us tomorrow, but he also never wanted any of the prominent children of God to suffer in any way, shape, or form. So as long as we are obedient to his word, he said he would give us the desires of our heart, but we got to do our part with that. We have to be more, we have to do more, we have to, and sometimes that requires you to do more in the church. Sometimes that requires you to do more in your family life. Sometimes that requires you to do more in your own life. Maybe you need to go to college. Maybe you need to get a college education. Maybe you need to teach your children how to be better children and how to respect adults. And how to not, you know, disrespect in the house. Sometimes it being more means that you have to overexert yourself. And when you overexert yourself, then that's when the glory and comes from the gain. But being more means that you have to also challenge yourself. You have to also challenge the areas in your life to where you don't feel that it's enough. You know, so sometimes you've got to challenge yourself and you've got to look at the things a little differently. You have to look at life a little differently and say, did I do enough? You know, did I work hard enough? Am I leaving a legacy for my children? What is it that I can do? How is it that I can be more than what I am? And it requires you to think outside of your own box. It requires you to say, okay, you know what? I'm going to do different. I'm going to be different. I'm going to do some different things. I'm going to challenge myself to be better, challenge myself to do better, challenge myself to just be something that God wants me to be instead of trying to be what you want to be all the time. When you change your perspective on what God wants you to be, He opens doors, He opens pathways that you never thought that would come. So the challenge is today is for you to be more, to do more. It requires you to dig deep sometimes. You have to dig deep and figure out what is it that God is trying to say that you need to do? What is it that God is trying to profess in your life that you need to change? What is it God is saying to do? Sometimes we get it so twisted that we always are worried about us and we're worried about what other people tell us that we are and who we should be and what we should do, that we don't follow God's plan. And God's plan is always going to be greater than our own plan. It's always going to be greater than somebody else telling you what you should be doing and what you shouldn't be doing. You know what I'm saying? It's like God is saying, be different. And when you are different in that regard, then God's going to change your perspective on your life. And He also is going to change your life. Because if you're doing the due diligence to serve Him and be obedient to Him and glorify Him and raise Him up and lift Him up, then He's going to turn around and do the same thing for you. Now, normally I talk about relationships and how this works in a relationship. Well, okay, your relationship is a good relationship. But guess what? Your relationship is also with God, too. Your relationship starts first with God. And then anything else after that is secondary. You know, if your marriage, that's secondary to God. You know, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, that's secondary to God. Your job, that's third as far as I'm concerned, because it should be your family. I mean, it should be God, your family. And then any other obligations come way after that. You know, so your job is not even ranked number one. So why in the world are you treating it like it's number one? Because you go into this job every day and you're giving more time to the job than you're giving to your family or you're giving to God. You know, God said, you don't have to work that hard. You don't have to do all of that. If you just trust and believe in me, He goes, I will give you what you need to sustain yourself. So, I mean, why are we don't have to work that hard. We don't have to go through all of those things. So, you know, it's kind of like, okay, so what's next? What do we do next? And that's when we have to realize that, you know, God requires more of us, you know, and there's a song, Give Me More, I Want More. I can't remember the name of it. It's something to that effect. It was playing in my head this morning, you know, God, I want more. But I wanted more of Him. I wanted more of what He could give me, you know. Am I married? No. You know, am I waiting on God? Absolutely. I'm waiting on Him because I know that if I go out and do this, it's going to fail. If I go out and say, you know what, I'm going to provide this for myself. I'm going to go out here and I'm going to find this man and I'm going to pursue him instead of him pursuing me. Well, guess what? When I pursue him, can I tell you how many times that's failed? It's failed so many times that's why I'm still single. Because I'm trying to do it myself. And I cannot do it myself. So the only thing that I can do right now is to be more. I have to be more. I have to be prepared for my husband. I have to do more, you know, to prepare for him. So if that means getting into the gym, that means losing weight, which is, you know, I'm on keto now, you guys. So this is like, you know, something different because I'm not a big meat eater. You know, so I'm trying to make this vegetarian keto work for me. You know what I'm saying? I'm preparing myself for my husband. I'm preparing myself for my house. I'm preparing myself for what God has for me. And God says that he was in my later years will be greater than my earlier years. Well, you know what? I'm in my later years right now. So God is saying, you know what? I'm going to prepare your table for you. And I'm setting it up. And you have to be ready for it, though. You have to do your part. So that's where I have to say to everybody is that's where you have to be more. That's where you have to do more. That is where you have to step outside of your box. And you're going to have to give God all the glory and all the honor and all the praise. And you are going to have to be more. That means be more of a wife, be more of a husband, be more of give more advice to your children, you know, better advice, be better for them, be a better example. Set an example for other people to follow, that they want to know who you are, because you're sitting up there and you're like, oh my gosh, you know what? They're seeing who you are and what you're doing. And they're like, I want to be like you. Well, don't be like me, be like God, because I'm an example of God. I'm not an example of somebody else. I am a product of my mother and a product of my father, but my mother has gone on and passed on to glory, and she's up there shining her lights down on me, you know, and through me, because I took a lot of what she, you know, the teachings that she had and the faith that she had, and the, you know, sometimes her faith did waver. Don't get me wrong, you know, because sometimes mine does too, but she was steadfast and she loved God so much. And so therefore that is where she instilled that in our family, to love God, you know, and cherish God and do God. You know, sometimes you got to do God. Sometimes you've got to, you know, Jesus is first. You know, the Holy Spirit is right there with him. You know, they all reside as one. You know, but we have to do our part, y'all. We have to do what God wants us to do. But we also have to stay in preparation, because we never know when God is going to change us. We never know when God is going to move. We never know when God is going to change our circumstances, and change it for the better. Because we're doing the will of God. So that's where I say, come to you. And I'm saying, if you're in a relationship or you're desiring to be in a relationship, you got to be a better you first. Be more than you've ever been, in order to, when you step out and you step out with, you know, your Gucci or your Louis or whatever your hair did, your nails did, the whole thing did, your husband's going to recognize you because of what you are and who you are. And he's not going to recognize you for your looks on the outward appearance. He's going to recognize that inward appearance, that you are strutting around and you're carrying yourself the way that you carry yourself. You know, because we can all look good. We can do it up, you know, the lashes and the lipstick and all of, and the nails and all of that stuff. We could all look good, but are we looking good for God, or are we looking good for man? Because we're supposed to be looking good for man. And if we're looking good for God, he's going to put every man that we've never even desired in our pathways. And it's going to be a good union, a cherished union, and a union that God has ordained. But you got to be more. You got to do more. And that's where I say, you know, you got to dig a little deep sometimes. Don't work too hard, because you may miss, you know, the blessing that is before you. But just work hard enough that when God gives you what you need to sustain you, then you can actually give your time and attention to your wife or your husband or your children, in different ways. Because, you know, your family is, you know, and your husband and your wife or future family or future wives that are coming along the way. You have to have time for them. You have to be prepared for them when they arrive. And sometimes we miss the mark, and we're so busy waiting, and sometimes they're right in front of us. Sometimes they're just right in front of our face and we don't even know it. And then sometimes we do have to wait. Sometimes we do have to be really patient, you know, because they're not there. But God is working on you. God is making you be more. God is making you do more. And when he does that, that's when you're going to be a greater you for your individual mate that is coming, you know, whether it's a man, woman, you know, whatever it happens to be. No judgments here. You know, you don't have to answer to me. You got to answer to God. But, you know, he will give you the desires of your heart. So I'm just coming to you today, and I just wanted to give you that little tidbit of information, that little word, a simple truth, as I call it. Be more. The simple truth is be more, do more, and God will give you more. All right, y'all have a blessed day. I am so happy that you are tuned into this live video. If you have any questions or comments that you would like to go ahead and post, I will go ahead and answer those for you. Again, tune in next week, Monday at 7:30 Pacific Standard Time, 10:30 Eastern Standard Time, because I do have a lot of people on the East Coast. So I just wanted to put that out there to you guys. But again, A Simple Truth with Stephanie Carew. And I will be with you next week. You can also catch me on Facebook Live on Thursday. I will be Facebook Live on Thursday night, again, at 7:30 Pacific Standard Time, 10:30 Eastern Standard Time. Again, Simple Truth, Facebook Live, and YouTube Live. So come on and check me out, and share these with somebody who just needs a simple truth today. And I will see you on Facebook Live on Thursday at 7:30. All right. And I also will see you on next Monday for another Simple Truth with Stephanie Carew. Have a blessed day.